Went to your mailbox today and you received a letter saying that there's a pandemic coming. How many of you are still complaining about slow service from our postal service?
Well, tonight some people in Baltimore were supposed to get a chance to voice their concerns directly to local leadership, but the meeting was canceled.
All right, WMAR 2 News' Ray Strickland explains how city officials say that they felt like it was a slap in the face to the people who want this service to be held up.
We have mail going everywhere. I have neighbors bring me mail at least once a week.
Residents living in the Waverly neighborhood in Baltimore say USPS has left them out to dry as their mail continues to show up late, or in some cases, not at all.
When you have to change your bank account because your information has gone to someone else, there's a big problem.
Frustrated neighbors joined city officials outside of the Waverly Post Office to voice their concerns.
Not only affecting a few people, but it's affecting the whole community. When you, like they say, can't pay your bills on time or your bills wind up late, you wind up with late charges because your mail didn't get through.
Councilwoman Odette Ramos says she expected to take part in a meeting to bring these issues directly to local USPS leadership, but she says it was canceled hours before it was set to begin.
That to me was just a slap in the face, and the fact that they did not want to be held accountable and actually work with us.
Late and missing mail are problems that have been plaguing residents throughout Baltimore for more than a year.
Literally, in some cases, lives are on the line. When seniors can't get their prescriptions, that has serious health consequences.
Councilman Zeke Cohen says he doesn't place the blame on mail carriers, but on the agency's leadership and mainly Postmaster General Louis DeJoy.
It is entirely unacceptable. Mr. DeJoy should be ashamed of the operation that he's run ever since he came in under the Trump administration, and we need to see better.
For these residents, the problems have gone on long enough, and they say it's about time something is done to fix it.
To think that this issue is something that can be ignored and unaddressed would be to stick your head in the sand as an ostrich and ignore the facts.